And we have here with us a couple of folks who have been involved personally in the EarthKAM project just recently. This is Frank Sanchez.
Hello.
And Luis Tamayo. They are a teacher and student, respectively, at Milstead Middle School here in town. And they just got finished going through a program with EarthKAM, right?
Correct. Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Well, real quick, Luis, how old are you?
12.
12, okay. And so 12 years old, and you have been able to help control something on the International Space Station, huh?
Mm-hmm.
That's really cool, right?
Yeah.
Well, what did you like about that?
Well, I like that it's all controlled by students instead of being more like less students. We can control more, and it feels like having the power.
So how does it work?
Well, basically, we go online and reserve a mission time, and it goes through an application process, and when the mission is going on, we're allowed to send in a target sheet, which coordinates different areas that we're used to or we would like to see from the International Space Station.
Okay.
And obviously, we were in with about 150 other schools,
right,
and they were all over the world. So that was fascinating, obviously, one of the drives, and we were really excited about that.
So how did it work for you, Luis? Did you get together with your classmates and talk about what you want to take a picture of? Or?
Yeah, oh, well, we were kind of like in a group deciding what we wanted to take pictures of, and then we finally decided what to take.
How did you decide? What did you talk about?
Well, we were talking more like adolescent talk, like, oh, this is cool, this is not cool, this is cool, this is not cool.
Well, I think we actually have some of your photos here,
right,
that we can show that y'all were involved in picking out. This first one, I think, is Chile.
Yes.
Yes.
Tell us about this.
Well, I really like that picture. We all decided to pick that picture. It's showing the coast of Chile. I really think it's an interesting picture.
Was there anything in particular that y'all were thinking about when you chose to take one of Chile?
Well, the landforms, we connected to social studies and landform and geographical features, mm-hmm, along with the science component. So that's really what drove our lesson. And Chile was obviously the coastline, and it's beautiful water, obviously the ocean. And you can see the differences in the type of features that are there. So
mm-hmm,
I thought it was an interesting choice. And obviously we had other images to choose from, but
sure,
that one really stood out for us.
Yeah, I think we've actually got one other one that y'all took. This
right
one is Alaska.
Yes, exactly.
Tell us about this one.
Well, Alaska, it's kind of special because it's in Canada, but it's part of U.S.
Right.
So
exactly,
it's some people got it confused with other places.
Mm-hmm.
But I was like, it's Alaska. And I really wanted to get a special picture.
Yeah. So this was one of your favorites?
Yes.
Right. It was one of mine also because of the barrenness and, you know, the dichotomy between ocean and, you know, is that landform? Is it ice? Is it ocean? You know, those kind of things. And then the colors really pop, too.
Yeah.
That's really,
if nothing else, it's a beautiful photograph.
It is a beautiful
but
photograph.
But I guess the idea is that kids actually learn something from doing this. So
right,
can you,
the connection.
Can you help us? What do you as a teacher see as the benefit of it?
Definitely. Well, I was part of the middle school aerospace scholars for 2 years, last year as well, and this is really how we got started with EarthKAM. You know, Dr. Sally Ride, her vision was, of course, to involve the students, especially here in America, to really take part in what's going on at the International Space Station and just in space in general.
Mm-hmm.
So I figured what would be a better way to, other than connecting it directly to the International Space Station, how as a teacher can we drive that and drive our lessons? So technology, one, and then of course the science behind it, and that's really what got us involved. And I've also done some webcasts with STEM, and they've talked a lot and used a lot of the images, so I figured how we could connect that without having to wait for a STEM webcast all the time, how we can consistently
do that. Real quick, just for people who don't know, what's STEM?
STEM is the science, technology, and educational through mathematics and science, okay? And they have a webcast. They do various programs through NASA, of course, and they do webcast. And the one that they used a lot of your images was a view from the top. And it basically talked about geological features. They were able to narrow down our school, and they found working with International Space Station images, some of the before and after photos too. So it was a very specific webcast as opposed to the general one that we took part in EarthKAM.
So are you, do you think you'll keep using this program in your
Definitely.
Classroom?
Or yes, we just missed the window for the past mission, but the one coming up in the right before summer, should we take part in that. And this class will actually help us with that, and then it'll carry over to some of the STEM webcasts that we'll be doing, kind of similar to what we did last time. And we'll be able to converse about the images and how they drive our lesson for this upcoming year.